Look, I used to teach the history of World War I, and my university, the University of Southern Mississippi, needed somebody to teach the Vietnam War. And I thought, wow, I get to teach the Vietnam War. I finally get to teach a war where there's veterans that can come speak to my class. And I was so lucky. I called the VA Medical Center in Gulfport, Mississippi, the same one that was destroyed by Hurricane Katrina later, and said, could my class come down and meet with a few of your veterans? And as it turned out, the woman who answered the phone was the head of the post-traumatic stress disorder clinic. Her name was Dr. Leslie Rue. And she thought, it'd be great for some of your students to meet with our veterans. And we went down there and were just held spellbound by those veterans. And one of them in particular just mesmerized me. He came up afterwards and said, wow, I never thought anybody would teach a class on Vietnam. Can I come take it? And I took a pretty big risk. I said, no, you can't come take it, but you can help me teach it. And he wound up being John Young, one of the central characters of the book. And as soon as I knew his story, and as soon as I knew more about the story of Charlie Company, I knew I needed to write that book about them. It wasn't the typical story that you see about Vietnam veterans. It was something different, something bigger, something new. And it took me a long time to write it because it took me a long time to convince myself that I was capable of writing it. They had such a good story. And I was only worried, could I convey that story in a way that people would actually get it? And I hope I did. I've assigned that book. I know a lot of my other colleagues at other universities, because I've now become a Vietnam War historian, we certainly assigned that book, and they do too. And it's very simply a part of that long time passing that we get to this point finally. She was totally right. It was when Saigon fell, I was 12. My older sister, her friends went off to fight that war. She's 8 years older than I. So I knew about it. I knew when she cried, when her friends didn't make it home. But it wasn't a war I understood. So I spent a lot of my life wanting to know more about that war, but nobody taught it. People weren't researching it back then. It was almost like a taboo. And the way I like to put it was like everybody in my life, from a parent to a teacher to a graduate school advisor, they were all telling me, don't go play there. That's taboo. Don't go there. So, of course, I had to go play there. I had to go look at it. It was a mystery that I couldn't solve. And so I gravitated towards it my whole life. I only studied World War I because nobody taught Vietnam back when I went to graduate school. My sister and her husband both were driving forces behind that. And my father was a driving force behind that. I was a very inquisitive child. And I remember watching the Vietnam news reports on television. And I would say, Dad, what is that? And he would literally admit to me he didn't understand what that was. And I asked my grandfather, what's that? And he had no explanation for it either. And that just, it floored me that the two most intelligent people I knew in my life, my father and my grandfather, were unable to explain this to me. So it was just, it had this attraction on me my whole life. And then I met John Young, and that attraction suddenly just blossomed into something I knew would. I was sitting in a pub in London one time talking to one of my World War I friends. And I told him the story that John Young had told me, and he looked at me and said, that's going to swallow you. And he was right. I've been working on that story ever since. That's a very tough one. The most important thing I got out of the whole process. A greater understanding of what that generation went through. I don't think that historians or the general public have really had a true understanding of what the Vietnam era generation went through. Our tendency is to look at it through movies, to look at it through the media, to either glorify it on one side or to damn it on the other. And neither of those aspects are reality. I think I got just a hint of what the reality of Vietnam was. And that was my goal, was to make that reality more accessible to more people.